That's how you do the biology. First things you want to do is you want to do a honk. It'll tell you the number of bodies in the system. Now, I've already scanned the system, so we won't see any along the FSS area here. But I already know that there's a biological on D7. The reason I know that is that when I zoomed in on it, so just do your normal standard exploration, and when you zoom in on it, it says features at the top right, just under the clock. And it says biological six. So there are six biological signs at this planet. So let's go ahead and land. Oh, sorry, we got to do a initial scan, surface scan of the actual planet. Okay, that's close enough. We can use four probes, so one, two, three, four. And what will happen is that the planet will scan and it'll have some various shades of blue green. Okay, so it's worthwhile. We have cactoida, bacterium, fungoida, stratum, frutexa, and tussock. Now, I quite like stratum, and so what we're going to do is we're going to focus in on that. And you'll see that with the different ones, we're actually seeing different amounts of blue on the planet, or green. It's a blue-greeny color. And what that is it's biome map. It is not a heat map, it's a biome map. And so when we get in closer, I'll show you on stratum that there are places that are actually better than others. But knowing where the better is just gained with experience. For example, Frutexa, Concha, and a few others like being in mountainous areas. Bacteria likes being on a flat surface. Stratum doesn't really mind where it is. It's pretty much everywhere, and you can find it everywhere, but there are places where it'll be easier to find than others. And I like craters. I like craters a lot. And so we're going to be looking for a crater as we come to land, and that'll be highlighted with a slightly brighter ridge. There's one. It's going to be a bit rocky, but you can sort of see on the screen now that there is a sort of a circle with a brighter area around it. And again, this is not a heat map. This is literally a biome map. And there are different biomes. There's a biome for stratum, fungoidea, cactoidea, bacterium, tussock. And you can see that with different plant types, there's different colorings and places where you can find it. So we're just going to come in and land here. And come into close range to the ground. And we can already see some stratum, and we can already, oops, see some bio. That's bacteria. Okay, so, but we're interested in that. That is stratum, hopefully, stratum tectonicus. Which is worth 19 million. So I did tell you that craters always work out for me for most things, not everything. There's a few like Frutexa and Concha that don't like it. Pretty sure this is stratum. We got first footfall. This is how you know that you're going to get first discovery.
Stratum tectonicus scanned.
Whoa!
Value 19,010,800. Minimum sample distance 500 meters.
Now the
sample scanned.
The game isn't doing that. There's a tool that I'm using that does that for me. And I'll show you the tool towards the end, but you don't need the tool. You can literally, up until this point, we've not used the tool at all. And finding more stratum is very easy. We just go and drive a little bit around the rim of the crater. And when it's far enough away, each plant species has its own distance. Some are 150 meters, some are 500. This is 500, for example. You need to be far enough away to get... You need to be far enough away to get biological diversity. That's the reason why. And we're just looking. That's tussock. We'll come back to that. And we're just looking. It's not unusual to need to look for a little while. There we go. More. And you need to take 3 samples in total. It's too close. That's what that means. You can find that in 2 ways. You can use the right mouse button and it will go blue, and that means it's too close. Purple means it's a different species altogether. Okay, everything here is too close. And we'll just try again. A little bit further away. Don't mind me parking. Parking is fun. Right clicking. Green. Green means ready to sample.
Second sample scanned.
Now, if you're not focused on that, you can use the right mouse button to find more of the same thing, but we're too close. This has only got a distance of about 100 meters. And you can sort of see that the purple ones are over there, but there's nothing happening over there. So that sort of shows you the range of the pulse on the right-hand mouse button. Okay, let's keep on going.
Minimum distance reached. You've traveled over 500 meters from previous sample.
And you just get used to finding it. What I would recommend in graphics settings is make sure that your distance forward is sufficiently far forward. If you've got the resolution set too high and you don't have what I have, which is 60 frames a second, it will actually truncate and show you less. Now we've collected the complete sample.
Sample complete.
And there might be some plants in the nearby area. So what we can do is I can use the right mouse button and listen for a return. Now, I can see over there some grass. So we're going to just walk over there and grab it. Sometimes it's helpful to have night vision on. Other times it's not.
Base value 1,766,600. Minimum sample distance 200 meters.
Say.
Sample scanned.
Say you didn't want that sample, and you just didn't want it, and you're going to scan something else. Well, if I tried to scan something else now, I wouldn't be able to. But what I can do is I can hold down the left-hand mouse button when I'm up close near another type of plant, and it will clear the collection. And there's some near my ship here. This may be far enough away because it only needs to be 200 meters. Yep, there's something over there that I can scan. And I just avoid the purple ones or the blue ones. They are not right. There's insufficient genetic diversity. But at a certain distance, 200 meters, it's fine. So we can get our second sample.
Second sample scan.
And as you're looking for things to scan, like bacteria, toxic, stratum, always be on the lookout for other types of plants as well, because you never know when you might want to come back. So we'll just do this one last one. We're looking for more tussock.
You've traveled over 200 meters from previous sample.
And this is actually hard to see from your ship. There it is. This will complete the tussock. And I've got four more plant life types to actually
sample complete.
Now, I know for a fact that although there's bacteria here, it may be time for me to show you the tool. The tool is called Elite Observatory, and the version is called Core. It actually has some plugins. And it's telling me that we actually have bacterium arsenium, which is only worth 1.658. Now, you can collect every one of them, and all power to you if you want to do that. But Cactoida and Frutexa, for example, are worth more, and therefore we might go to space and see what we can do. But Fungoida, for example, is worth even more than those. And so we're going to go to space, change the biome to Fungoidea, and then go and see if we can find Gelata or Cetasis. At this moment, the tool doesn't know if it's going to be Gelata or Cetasis, and there's a difference in price as well. They still have the same distance of 300 meters. Now, if you're interested in this observatory core, I'll put it into the description, and you can go grab it from there. This plugin is also an extra plugin. You have to download that separately. So we need to go to space, and we're going to find Fungoidea. And the reason why I want to show you Fungoidea is that Fungoidea likes mountainous areas, and the bright areas aren't necessarily the best places to go. So it's sort of a rough, bright, dark blue. There's no other way of describing it. I'll show it to you when we get up to space. We've changed the biome type to Fungoidea. And because it's a bit fussy, it may not be everywhere on the planet. So we'll get quite high before we come back down. Orbital cruise is far enough. As you can see, it's not available in every single place like the others were. And there's a sort of a boundary between this bright blue and this darker blue. And that, for Fungoidea, is the perfect place. The bright blue, which you'd think is awesome, if it was a heat map, that's not the way it works. It's a biome map. And so what we're looking for is that interface between them. And again, there's only really about 10 types of plants, and knowing what each type likes will help you be successful at hunting them. So we're going to go for this sort of interface region, looking for Fungoidea. And those mountains are perfect. Now, this is a very particular plant. It likes particular places, and it's not easy to find. And so we're just going to keep on looking until we find it. Once you find it, it's relatively straightforward to scan it. So we'll end the video upon that, but I just wanted to show you looking for different types of biomes and the fact that the biome map isn't a heat map, it is a biome map. Now, we haven't seen any yet, which sort of makes me worried that we've gone into the wrong area. And that's okay. The main thing is set yourself a time limit so that if you aren't finding anything, talk of the devil, you put a limit on it. And so I know from experience, this is Cetasys, which is a type of Fungoidea. Having a small ship really helps. Medium and large ships are difficult to land where Fungoidea, Cactoidea, Concha, and a couple of others like to be. Okay, so we're just deleting the tussock sample and we're going to go to Cetasys.
Fungoidea Cetasys scanned. Base value 1,670,100. Minimum sample distance 300 meters. First sample scanned.
And that's basically it. Rinse and repeat until you've got all the samples that you want, or all of the samples on the planet. And what you'd want to do is hand it in at the local Vista Genomics, and you get a payday. It pays very well. Now, to get Elite in Exobiology requires 8.5 billion credits worth of sales. And you're thinking that's a lot of money. It's enough for a carrier, but it's not that hard to actually create that amount of money through Exobiology, particularly if you do stratum tectonicus, just like I've done. And so with that, just before we get to the 20-minute mark, we will leave it. Thank you so much for watching, and if you find this interesting or have any questions, please reach out to me.